I must say that the honourable gentleman is possibly generating more alarm than he realises. The idea that there is going to be some compromise between the two sides of the House on this question does, in relation to the red lines, does actually raise a very simple question, and it's this. Would the honourable gentleman like to state on behalf of the opposition that they would like to see the repeal of the repeal of the European Community Act 972?
Mr. Speaker, I'm grateful for that intervention. Because what it demonstrates is the point I was trying to make about the customs union, which is if the government front bench say our political declaration is in effect a customs union by a different name, because we're going to build on the backstop and make it permanent and turbocharge it, I suspect there's going to be a degree of opposition to that, if I've understood anything about debates that have been going on here for some considerable time. And that's where the difference is. As for the repeal of the 72 Act, I have always said, and stand by it, that repealing that Act and putting a date for leaving in the Withdrawal Act was a mistake, and I've always, because of the transition period. And I've always said that the Act we've passed will have to be repealed before it comes into force, and so it will. The implementation bill, the white paper, specifically says it's going to.